Hi everyone, this is Eiffel. This topic I will talk about Delta Inverter Built-in PLC function, especially focus on how to establish the connection. Here we'll use MS300 as example, so you can see we link the USB to USB Type B connector to MS300. And you may wonder how about other Delta Inverter. So here we'll show you we can use also the IFD converter. That means from USB to RJ45, then we can use the LAN cable connect to the inverter. So normally we'll suggest you use the IFD 6530, then with the LAN cable, so you can connect to C2000 series, ME series, E and EL series. And for MS300, we can simply use the USB to Type B USB cable. And for sure, you can also use the IFD then link to the RJ45 port here. This page will simply give you a concept of Delta Inverter built-in PLC capacity, how many steps you can write for a program. And basically, today's example, I will show you based on ISP SOAP with the com manager. And here, just let you know three functions of PLC. So if you see the PLC 0, that means no disable PLC function. PLC 1 means PLC run, and PLC 2 means PLC stop. And here we will talk about some important parameters for inverter. So most of you should know that the 0900 is for inverter station ID or station address. This is the default value is 1. And for PLC, we will use another ID address. So this one default value is 2. Regarding baud rate and protocol is up to your application. Then this is what I already mentioned for M300 series and C series. The name will be slightly different. M300 series will be PLC0, PLC1, and PLC2. So as you can see here, PLC2 means a PLC stop. And you can press this one button to decrease the value to PLC1. That means a PLC run. And press again, you go back to PLC0. So that means we can disable PLC function. And this one already mentioned, here you can see once we power on, actually will show the frequency. Then you can press a more button 5 times until it show a PLC 0. But as you know, PLC 0 is disable PLC function, so you can press the upper button to PLC 1 or PLC 2, then press enter. And C series, you can press the menu, then go to item 10, PLC, and press enter. Then select a PLC run or PLC stop. Here we'll talk about the I/O mapping. So this is the default for inverter. That for MS300, we have the 7 input and 2 output. So the input we will call MI1 to MI7, but in PLC we'll define it in X0 to X7. And digital output in inverter is MO1, MO2, and in PLC we'll call Y0 and Y1. Here is an important concept that once you define, you use this MI or MO in PLC program, then you cannot use the parameter to define this anymore unless you disable the PLC function. Okay, so here I will give you some simple example. Okay, once you see the detecting is success, then remember to set the driver, and then we can back to ISP SOAP. And here, if you still remember, please change the station address to 2. Reason is here. 1 means the inverter itself, but today we will use a PLC function, so remember change to 2. Okay, and we can check the connection status. So we can see, and we create a simple program. Okay, then we can download the program. And basically, this one will show you two concepts. First one is we can use the digital input to control the output. Second one is I will use the D100 to change the frequency, maximum frequency in P10. Okay, then we go online. And you can see the status is stop, so we can change the mode from inverter panel, then set to PLC1. So you will see this one switch to run, and then we can remove the digital input. So you will see once we remove, then the signal will off and put it back. Okay, next we'll show you we change the frequency to 100 Hz, and we can check from sorry, for here I have to stop. Okay, once we connect, and we can create a new project. So you can see now we already connect, and let's go here to check the parameter. As I mentioned, this one will change the P100, so we can check the status. And you can see the value is 100 Hz, and we can change from here again. But sorry, here we have to disconnect first, and we online and modify the value to 5000, that means 50 Hz. Okay, so you can see now it become 50 Hz. So this one just give you a simple concept about Delta inverter PLC function. Thank you.